हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल बेटा। सो आर यू स्टडिंग एट होम? वी स्टार्टेड चैप्टर 5 इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, कंप्यूटर वायरस। सो क्विकली वी विल हैव अ ब्रीफ रिकैप ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव डन इन दिस एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट अहेड। कंप्यूटर वायरस, व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर वायरस? A virus that attacks a computer is actually a computer program. It is basically a set of instructions and it is deliberately written by some bad guys. We have done that. A virus program is not always harmful. There are some virus programs which are not that harmful. They are just created for fun, but still they are very annoying. A computer virus in real terms is a program. They can copy itself. They can make n number of copies of itself, and the full form of virus is vital information resources under seize. Okay, now what are the harms that a computer virus can cause? What are the harms that a computer virus can cause, and what are the symptoms? How do we come to know that a virus attack is there on the system? So how do we get to know that how a virus comes to the system? Through an infected CD or pen drive, through email attachments, visiting malicious websites, downloading infected files, starting an infected application. These all things creates a virus in your system. Now what kind of harms a virus can cause is like it will eat up all space. Eat up all space means it will fill up the all space in your computer system, and when you will try to store something on your computer, it will not have space for that. Or it can delete your files. Suppose there are some important files which are stored on the computer, and it can delete those files. And it can steal your account number and password also. These days we are doing internet banking, all the transactions we are doing through internet, online we are doing all the things. So if virus is there, it can also steal your account number and password. So, and this process happens so quickly that you may not even be aware of the presence of virus in your computer. Means आपको पता भी नहीं चलेगा कि कंप्यूटर के अंदर वायरस है और कंप्यूटर वायरस ने ऐसा किया, ठीक है? देन हाउ डू वी गेट दैट? वी हैव डिस्कस इफ वी पुट अ इन्फेक्टेड सीडी, इफ यूज अ इन्फेक्टेड पेन ड्राइव, थ्रू ईमेल अटैचमेंट और थ्रू द एप्स दैट वी डाउनलोड, इफ दे हैव नॉट बीन डाउनलोडेड फ्रॉम द ऑथेंटिक साइट्स, देन देयर कुड बी अ वायरस इनसाइड. Now history of computer virus also we did in the previous session. Now when virus came into existence? In the 1980s. When it came into existence? In the 1980s. And the first PC virus was a boot sector virus. What was the name of that? C-Brain. What was the name? C-Brain. And it was created in 1980. And who created it? There were two brothers, Basit and AFLB. These two brothers created this C-Brain virus. Okay. Now, since the mid 1990s, macro viruses have become common. Most of these viruses are written in the scripting languages. Scripting languages you will learn when you will come into the classes like 9, 10, you will come, you will learn about scripting languages. Okay, these viruses spread by Excel spreadsheets. Excel we use, so these viruses can spread even by using Excel spreadsheet or other Microsoft Office documents. So now one of the most common means of virus infection is through instant messaging. Nowadays we are using a lot this instant messaging, so it also spreads virus. Now there was a virus, Elk Corner virus, and it was originally a joke. Means it started as a joke only, and it was created by a high school student. High school student means a school student who is studying in 10th standard, 9th standard. So it was attached to a game. The virus gets released on the 50th time. Means if a person will play that game 49 times, nothing will happen. But if the person will play that game 50th time, then this virus will get activated. Okay? And this way this virus affects. Then next we did types of computer viruses. Now how many types of computer viruses we did? Bombs, boot sector viruses, email viruses, Trojan horses, worms, and spyware. In the previous session, I said to you that you find out about Trojan horse, or you find the story behind this Trojan. So you might have done that. It was an interesting story. Now, what are bombs? What they do? These viruses, they activate themselves after a specific time period, and they cause damage to the computer system. Then boot sector virus, which affects the boot sector or the area of system which is used in the booting process. And what was the booting process? The process of starting up system is called the booting process. Now email virus, these viruses transmit through emails and the attached files. So when the person opens the attached file, the virus copies itself to his or her computer. Means you got a mail, you opened it, and you got the virus. And these mails generally come from the unknown people, जिनको हम जानते नहीं हैं, ठीक है? वहाँ से हमारे पास कोई मेल आया, हमने ओपन किया, and what was there inside? Nothing. Virus got transmitted to our system. Okay. Then Trojan, which doesn't seem like a virus and which appear to be friendly. Appear to be friendly means वो आपको अच्छे लगते हैं, फ्रेंडली लगते हैं. जैसे आपने सिस्टम ऑन किया एंड समबडी इज़ विशिंग यू हैप्पी बर्थडे, समबडी इज़ लाइक यू गेट अ मैसेज ऑफ हैप्पी न्यू ईयर. ओके, बट यू फील नाइस ना दैट समबडी इज़ विशिंग यू. बट व्हाट हैपन्स इन द बैकग्राउंड, व्हाट हैपन्स, इट इज़ अ मलेशियस प्रोग्राम एंड इट्स डूइंग लाइक हार्म टू योर कंप्यूटर. देन वॉर्म्स, वॉर्म इज़ अ मलेशियस प्रोग्राम दैट डुप्लीकेट्स इटसेल्फ. डुप्लीकेट मीन्स अपनी कॉपीज बना लेना. दे इवेंचुअली फिल अप द डिस्क स्पेस. क्या करते हैं वो, अपनी इतनी कॉपीज क्रिएट करते हैं कि वो पूरा डिस्क स्पेस फिल कर देते हैं, ठीक है? देन स्पाईवेयर. स्पाईवेयर इज अ कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर दैट इज इंस्टॉल्ड सीक्रेटली ऑन अ कंप्यूटर. मीन्स सीक्रेटली वो आपके सिस्टम पर इंस्टॉल किया जाता है टू गेट द पर्सनल इंफॉर्मेशन विदाउट योर knowledge. Okay, so these were the types that we did. Now we will do malware. Now what is malware? Malware is derived from two words, malicious and software. It is a combination. Basically mal we have taken from malicious and where we have taken from software. Okay, so malicious software is malware. So it is a software designed to damage the data computer system without the owner's knowledge or consent. Consent means permission. Means ये जो malware होता है ये हमारी permission के बिना हमारे computer को harm करता है, ठीक है? Malware includes computer viruses, worms, Trojan horses, spyware and other malicious and unwanted software. तो जितने भी हमने types of computer viruses करे हैं they all come under the category of malware. They all are called malware. Now protecting your computer, like so many threats are there, so many malware are there, how can we protect our computer? Kaise hum protect karenge? So it's a difficult task really when you are using internet. These days we are using lots of internet, so it's really difficult for us to save our system from viruses. So how to do that? Viruses affect, in fact, a computer system, and how do they spread? That we know that through CDs they spread, through pen drive they spread. So what we have to do, we have to take care following points. What are those points that we have to take care? First is, do not use the CD or the pen drive received from another person unless you are certain that the device does not contain a virus. So first is like we should not use the CD or pen drive given by a person just like that only. We should make sure that that CD or that pen drive is not infected. Then second, do not download program or other information from non-reputed sources on the internet. Hamein non-reputed sources like which are not the authentic websites, we should not download programs from there. Then be careful of the attached file you received in your email. Open only those files sent by the people you trust. Means if unknown people are sending us files, we should not open those files. Okay, we should open only those files which are sent to us by trusted people, means by our known people. Okay, now restrict access to your system. Restrict access to your system means don't let others use your system, don't let others access your system. Then last is install an antivirus program on your computer. What we should do, we should install a antivirus program on our computer. Now what is this antivirus program? As the name suggests, anti means against. Okay, so the one who take care of virus is called antivirus. So antivirus program, it checks the file on your computer to detect the viruses and also remove them. There are many antivirus programs available in the market. You may install an antivirus program on your computer to prevent it. So there are some examples that you are having in your book also. So these examples are Norton, Kaspersky, McAfee, F-Secure, AVG, K7, Endpoint Security. So these are some of the examples, or we can say these are some of the popular antiviruses that we are using to protect our system. Now using antivirus software, how we can use our antivirus software? So what does this antivirus do? Actually it scans your system. Whenever you switch on your system, this antivirus, if it is installed on your computer, what it will do, it will scan your system. Or if you are like using a pen drive or CD, then if antivirus is installed, what this antivirus will do, it will scan that CD or pen drive first, only then it will read it. Okay, so now there are some steps for scanning your computer if antivirus is installed. Right now I think there is no antivirus right now in my system because I have just formatted it a few days back. No, there is no antivirus. Otherwise anti-malware is there one, okay, but not exactly the antivirus, so I cannot show you how to do that, but I'll tell you the steps with the pictures how to do that. To scan your computer using Kaspersky, specifically if we are using this Kaspersky antivirus, these are the steps for that, but like steps are almost same for all the antiviruses. Okay, so if an antivirus is installed, what we will do? We will do double click on that. So here it is written only that, the double click the Kaspersky Internet Security icon from the system tray. System tray, what is system tray? Which comes here, see, this is called system tray. Can you see my cursor? Yes, here this is system tray. This is system tray. It's having some tools inside it. So similarly your antivirus will also come here in the system tray. This, see, byte fence anti malware, it's coming. So similarly if you are having that Kaspersky, that will be depicted here in this system tray. So now what we have to click on that icon if we want to use it, then click, we have to click the scan option. So when we use that scan option, some screens appear like, do you want the full scan? Then you click on this and the scan will complete after some time. Okay. Now scanning external devices. Now what are external devices? External devices, as I told you, devices which are edged from outside. Like if we are talking about CD-ROM. So it's a external device. We are putting it in our laptop or system. Similarly, a pen drive. What is that? That is an external device. We are using it from outside only. So if antivirus is installed, then what will happen? It will immediately ask you to scan it. Just, and what we have to do? We have to click the scan option. As soon as we are inserting a pen drive or we are inserting a CD, what it will ask? It will ask us to scan that. See here, you can see it on the screen also. It will ask us to scan, and or the scanning will start. The process of scanning starts if the device contains virus. The antivirus displays an alert message. Suppose if the pen drive or the CD that you have inserted, it's having an virus inside it, so antivirus will show you an alert. After the scan finishes, a window appears displaying the message, scanning of this is completed. And if virus is there, it can give you an alert, as well as it, to some extent, it can like destroy that also, or it can clean that file, or it can delete also. At times it will ask you like if you want to delete this file which is infected by the virus. So if you delete that file, that particular virus also gets deleted with that file. So this way we can scan it. Now updating antivirus software. How we can update antivirus software? As we know, like every day new viruses are coming. So if new viruses are coming, we need to update our antivirus also. So antivirus software needs to be updated regularly so that it can detect new viruses before initiating the updation process. First connect the computer system to the internet. So if you are updating your antivirus software, first what you should do, you should update your computer system, or you should connect your computer system to the internet, and you have to follow the given steps. Like in case of Kaspersky Internet Security, it is given, you open that and you click on run update. What will happen? Windows will appear and your antivirus software will get updated. Okay. Now the chapter is over. Quickly, key points what we did. First, we did computer virus. It is a computer program that cause harm to the computer. Then your system cannot develop a virus on its own. अपना आप से वायरस नहीं बनता. हाउ इट कम्स? इट कम्स फ्रॉम द एक्सटर्नल डिवाइसेस और फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट. ईदर इट इज़ कमिंग फ्रॉम अ पेन ड्राइव और इट इज़ कमिंग फ्रॉम सी डी और इट इज़ कमिंग फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट. इफ़ यू आर डाउनलोडिंग समथिंग फ्रॉम इंटरनेट फ्रॉम द अनऑथराइज वेबसाइट्स. ओके. देन देयर आर मैनी टाइप्स ऑफ वायरसेस इन डिफरेंट पीपल मे डिस्क्राइब दैम इन डिफरेंट वेज. वॉट इज़ द कलेक्टिव टर्म विच इज़ यूज फॉर ऑल काइंड ऑफ malwares is viruses is called malware, and full form of malware is malicious software. What is full form of malware? Malicious software. So the most common and useful means to protect your computer from a virus is to use an antivirus software. So if we want to save, we want to protect our computer from a virus, what we should use? We should use an antivirus software. This was all in this chapter. Now in the next session, we will do the exercise and question answers of this chapter. Okay. And after that, we will start with chapter 6, which is Adobe Flash. And there are some extra topics also in your book. So we will see if we can do one extra topic also. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you.